Hey guys, welcome back. So I've got a tutorial for you today using the Kat Von D Chrysalis palette. And I was hoping that I could get around to film at least one tutorial for you guys. And so I did today. I really like the way it came out. It's kind of a purpley eye and it's got a really light inner lid and it's kind of warm in the crease. And then it's got a fun little pop of blue on the lower lash line. So I really like the way it came out. I love this palette. It is so amazing. I have a whole review and swatches video on it. I'll link that down below. I also love the Monarch palette, which is the more kind of neutral palette from Kat Von D. I have a review and swatches video on that one and some tutorials. So any videos that I have to do with this palette or the Monarch palette, I'll link them down below for you guys so you can check those out if you want to. But anyway, yeah, I really like this look. I have no idea what to call it, but if you want to see how to do it, this kind of purpley, light, slightly warm in the crease, I don't know, sort of collective eye look using the Chrysalis palette, then just keep watching. Okay, we're gonna start by priming our eyes. I'm gonna use my Wet n Wild Fergie eyeshadow primer. Next, I'm gonna take MAC's Painterly Paint Pot and apply that to the top half of my lids just to cancel out discoloration. Now grab some kind of a creamy base. This is Barely Branded by Maybelline. I don't remember if this was one of the limited edition ones or not, but just anything that's kind of a champagne-y kind of a shade and apply that to your lids. Now we're gonna go in with our palette and get some of Glasswing on a blending brush and we're going to take and apply that into our transition area right above your crease. I feel like I said that really weird, transition area. But anyway, just apply that right there. Now we're gonna take some of Lunar Lights and I'm using a concealer brush, so just any kind of a flat shader brush will work. And apply that to the inner half of your lids. Now I'm gonna take another flat brush and I'm gonna get some of Mezzanine. And we're gonna apply that kind of to the middle part of your eyelid. And you might have to build this up. It's very pretty, but it does take a little bit of building, not much. And it does have some fallout. But we can just wipe that away. Next, I'm gonna apply some of Hybrid Moments to the outer part of my eyelid, just in your outer crease. And then slowly blend that over into your crease. Did I say outer crease or outer corner? Outer corner, and blending over into your crease. And now you can go back in with a little bit of Mezzanine just to brighten that back up and get that vibrancy back. And also brighten up Lunar Lights just a little bit. And now I'm going to apply some of Lifelike as my brow bone highlight. And now to add just a little bit of fun, I'm going to get some of Entombed on a kind of a flat brush. And we're gonna apply that to our lower lash line. And then apply some of Hybrid Moments to your outer corner. And then I'm gonna take some of Lunar Lights on the inner part of my lower lash line, just to really brighten that up. And then take your favorite eyeliners. I'm gonna be using the Physicians Formula Eye Booster. This is in Ultra Black. And then I meant to grab, this is the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide On Eye Pencil. This is in Perversion, but I meant to grab my Velvet one in Black Velvet. I like that one more, but this is what I have, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna line my upper lash line with the Physicians Formula and do a little bit of a wing, and then I'm gonna line my lower lash line and my waterline with this one. And then just curl your lashes and apply your favorite mascara. I'm going to be using the CoverGirl Clump Crusher and the Jordana Best Volume Extreme Volumizing Mascara. Alright guys, so here is the finished look. I hope you like it. Just stay tuned to find out what I used on the rest of my face. For foundation today, I'm wearing the CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous Foundation. I really like this. I'm wearing it in 110, that's my shade, and it seems to work fine for my skin tone. I just really like this, it's a very good foundation. And then I set it with the e.l.f. High Definition Powder. I love this, I talk about it a lot. If you've never tried it, it's amazing. You should give it a shot. For bronzer today, I've got the Jane Bronzing Powder in Inspire. This is just a beautiful bronzer. It's great for contouring. It's great for warming up your complexion. It's just great, and it's really a fairly inexpensive bronzer. It's not like $2 or $3, but it's like, I think, $10 or $11, which is, you know, pretty affordable, and it's great. I love it. And then for blush, I've got Max Melba. This is like a cult favorite. It is amazing. It's just like a beautiful warm shade, and it goes with so many different things. I love pairing a kind of like peachy cheek and peachy lip with a kind of cool toned purpley eye or even a blue eye. I just like the kind of contrast. But then also when you use like a warm sort of shade in your transition area, I feel like it kind of ties it all together. So there's still things that go together, but then there's also contrasting colors as well. So it just makes a more complex makeup look. So I love Melba. I think it's beautiful. Stays on really well on the skin. It's gorgeous. And then for my highlighter, this is the Wet n Wild Fergie Center Stage Collection. This was limited edition, so I don't know if you can still find it, but this is in Video Bomb. It's just a really pretty kind of like rose gold, pinky bronzy sort of a highlight. It's beautiful, I love it. And then for my lips, I've got on, this is Wet n Wild's matte lipstick in 903C and just peachy, love it. It's just a nice matte peachy lip. And then to give it some shine and some gloss, I've got the NYX Butter Gloss in Maple Blondie. And it's just kind of a nice, it's sort of a slightly pinky peach. But I just really, I like the combo together, and again, it's that peachy look with the more kind of cool-toned eye. So that's what I've got on the rest of my face. Alright guys, so that is the finished look and tutorial. I hope that you really enjoyed it. Let me know, what kind of looks have you been doing with the Chrysalis palette? Do you own it? Do you love it? What do you like about it? Do you go for more of the like purpley sort of shades? Or do you go for more of the like blue shades or the gray ones? There's a lot of different beautiful colors in this palette. And actually, if you have the Wet n Wild Petal Pusher palette, the purpley one, you could get a very similar look to this eye look. You would just need to bring in some sort of a warm shade in your crease and you'd be good to go. So if you have that palette, let me know what combos you do with it too, because I love that one also. But anyway, that's the one that I use today, this palette right here, and I love it. So anyway, that's the look. I hope that you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to my channel if you're not already, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.